Hi, I'm Kavita.
Hi, I'm Marzban. Welcome to Torque,
the car and bike show from NextGen Publishing Limited. The NextGen house belongs to Forbes Group, HDFC and the Bauers from Germany.
In fact, we are leading publishers in the automotive space.
Our most popular magazines are Car India, Bike India and CV, that's Commercial Vehicle.
And what we're going to bring you is a program every week which is going to educate you on the right set of wheels that you need to buy.
Welcome to the show. This week's show, we have tested the Hyundai i10.
Also, the three best bikes in the 150cc segment.
Watch out the tips of the week.
But let's begin with the news desk section.
Welcome to the news desk. We're now updating you with the happenings of the past 2 weeks from the world of cars and bikes.
The much-awaited Jetta from Volkswagen Group is about to be launched in about a couple of months' time. It is going to compete with the Skoda Laura and it is going to be priced much lower than the Passat. Watch out for that car.
The next launch from the Hyundai stable is going to be the i20, which is going to hit the markets by the end of the year. And to settle all doubts, the i20 is not replacing the Getz. In fact, the Getz is going to be in production for a while. The i20 is going to come down in competition with the Maruti Suzuki Swift and Skoda Fabia.
Nissan Renault have finally announced the Bhumi Pujan date for their plant in Chennai. It's going to be June of 2008. But the first car, the small car, will be rolling out late 2009. Now let's get to the news from the exciting world of bikes.
The latest bike to launch from the TVS stable is the Flame. This 125cc bike has a single spark plug, front disc brakes and digital meters. It is going to be competitively priced in the 125cc segment.
The finance minister in the latest budget has offered some financial sops to the auto industry. Especially for the small car segment, there is a duty cut from 16 to 12% and for the two-wheelers, it is from 14 to 12%. And what we hear is that all of it is going to be passed to you, the end consumer.
Ferrari's Kimi Raikkonen has won the last week's F1 race in Spain. This now puts Ferrari in a leading position where drivers and constructors' championship is concerned.
Now let me tell you about the biggest launch of the year, the i10 from Hyundai. This car has won many accolades and many awards during the year. To tell you more on that, over to my colleague Kavita.
The i10 has won the prestigious NDTV Profit Award and the iCorti Award.
To throw more light on its features and bearings, over to Aspi Bathena, who is the editor of Car India magazine, a very well-known prestigious magazine.
Hi, this is the new Hyundai i10, which has really rocked the country just now with all the awards that she's won. You can see the chrome monogram with the Hyundai badge standing right in the front proudly. She's got the largest headlights in the segment merging into the bodywork. She's got this big air dam which gives her a nice chunky look. She also has these wide 155/80/13 tires, the biggest for the segment. The side on, she's a little plain, but she has been given this wedge cut here to give it a bit of a shape here. The tail lamps really merge well into the car. It gives her a nice look. She carries this Car of the Year sticker proudly. The boot space is okay. It's not too big, not too small. It's okay for this segment. This folds up. You can put a larger bag inside this. Or you can even fold the seats forward if you want to carry some real large objects. The white, light beige colored upholstery looks very nice when it's new, but I would like to see what it looks like after 6 months, because Indian conditions, there's a lot of dirt and muck around, which makes it very difficult to keep this interiors clean.
This is the power plant of the new i10, Hyundai i10. This is the 1.1 liter engine. This is also being used by the Santro, the same engine, basically the same engine, but this has been modified and tweaked to give better mid-range performance as well as refinement, and does a wonderful job in this car. Though we would like to have a slightly larger engine for this car to give better efficiency and performance. So this is the heart, the three-valve 1.1 liter engine.
It's got a host of good features like the adjustable steering. You can adjust the steering exactly to your height that you want. And so it's not many cars in this segment have this facility. Okay. Release the handbrake. Select the first gear. It's a smooth select. Switch on the AC. This round rotary AC switches are very nice and convenient to use. And so now let's take it for a drive and see what she's all about. We're driving along on the Mahabaleshwar Satara Road. There's not much body roll around corners as well. It's quite good. So the tires do let off a squeal when they are pushed hard. But that's expected from a car of this segment and size. The steering is quite precise and light and gives a good feedback. And anything from 1500 RPM, she's happy to pull along into fifth. 50-55 kmph. Gear shift is short and positive and smooth, easy to select. The clutch is very light. It should be easy for lady drivers to drive this car. The road noise also seems to be okay. There's not much of road noise. Road holding of the car also is decent. The ride quality is good. The 155 AT profile tires give a good amount of grip as well as a good ride quality. She's quite good round corners also. We are cruising along in fifth gear. Not a problem at all. Just been going over some rough road surfaces and she's handled it quite nicely. The 1.1 engine has a decent spread of power, nice and comfortable. We are motoring along at around 80 kilometers an hour. No doubt she's won a lot of awards this year. She deserves it. I think she's redefined the small car segment. The only negative points that I would feel about the car is I would say is the engine could have been slightly larger, more modern, more fuel efficient and more powerful. Otherwise this car's been quite good. No doubt it has set a new benchmark in this segment.
Now here's some trivia for you. Could you tell us who is the first automobile manufacturer to have mass production of cars in the world? Answer after the break. Well folks, let's slip into a commercial break, but on the other side, we bring you the 150cc shootout of the three best bikes in the country. Also, the tips and tricks of the week. Now after a break, we bring you the three 150cc bikes, the best three bikes in the country. The Apache RTR, the Pulsar 150 and the Unicorn. Expert comments from Aspi Bathana. Bike India editor.
We got three 150s on test. It's the most fiercely contested segment. Every manufacturer has a bike in this segment today. We'll start with the Pulsar DTSI 150. The DTSI stands for Dual Spark Ignition System. The Pulsar has been around the longest. This is the twin spark plugs. This has been around for the longest period now. It has gas-filled shocks. The Pulsar has aged well. She's still not like a long in the tooth. She still performs well. The only negatives I would say is the engine refinement is poor and the gear shift is not really good. The gear selection is not the best in class. She performs decently. She has a decent performance, decent fuel efficiency. The few bikes in this segment to have a digital speedometer and analog RPM meter. So I think equipment wise, she also has LED brake lights, tail lamp and brake lamp at the back. And she also has a mudguard hugger, which none of the other bikes feature. Now from Pulsar, we move on to the Unicorn. The only motorcycle in the segment in India to have a monoshock rear suspension. This monoshock rear suspension gives this bike the best ride quality and handling in the country probably today. And the Unicorn has a very smooth and refined engine. She's more of a user-friendly bike. She does everything well without any fuss and is the easiest and the most comfortable bike to ride. If you are looking at a comfortable bike to commute and not have any hassles, I think the Unicorn is the way to go. Okay, she does not have the LED lights, nor does she have the digital meter. She's got the old analog type speedo and RPM. And the single spark plug engine delivers decent performance, hardly any vibrations. And really the engine is the smoothest. Sometimes when it's switched on, you really have to see whether it's really on or off. It's that quiet, the engine. We will move on now to the RTR 160 Apache. The RTR 160 Apache is all about performance. The first thing she has that no other bike in India has is this petal type disc in up front. They don't care about the vibration or the harshness it goes because you're only looking at performance. Then she has this clip-on handlebars which are adjustable for your ride comfort. Also has a digital speedo and also has a digital display of clock, and it has a service interval display. It's got a host of features. Also has the most potent engine at 15.5 bhp. It is also the sharpest handling bike of the lot. It has got the shortest wheelbase. The handling is really sharp. This also has gas-filled shocks at the back. She also has the LED lights at the back. And this is all, if you want performance, then this is the bike for you. First and foremost, you must maintain the correct tire pressures recommended by the manufacturer. In this case, 33 up front and 35 PSI at the back.
Okay.
And especially when you're traveling on the expressway, you'd rather have a slightly over-inflated tire than an under-inflated tire.
Okay. So you recommend that a tire which is slightly inflated better on the highway works better?
Yes, because it's safer, because there's less heat buildup.
Okay.
Okay.
What about these tire treads? What do you need to do? When do you need to look at the tire treads?
You have to keep a constant eye on your tire tread. And
okay.
There should be at least a minimum 1.5 mm depth at any given time and all around the tire, just not in the place where there's more tread and less.
Okay.
Minimum is 1.5. If anything less than that, you must replace the tire.
Okay. And when do you recommend a tire change for a car?
It depends from car to car and driver to driver. But
okay.
Some cars you may need in 20,000 kilometers, some may go up to 40,000 kilometers.
Okay.
It varies on how you drive your car and how much power your car is putting
okay.
out. It's on depends on your driving style.
Okay. Aspi, could you tell us more on how you do the basic maintenance of your air filter and stuff like that?
Yeah, I'll show you the basic maintenance, what you need to look after your car, which you can do yourself at home.
Okay.
You should regularly check the engine oil.
Okay.
And make sure there are two levels. One is the lower level and one is the higher level. So the oil is between these two and more towards the high level.
Okay.
And not overfill it also, because the overfilling oil also creates extra pressures in the engine.
Okay.
So that's regular check out once in 15 days or month.
Okay.
Is recommended.
And definitely before you go out on a long vacation.
Yes, definitely before a long drive.
Long drive.
Okay. Okay. Then this is the coolant level. There are levels here, so coolant always must be on the higher side, which is also normally topped up with distilled water. Another thing that you can do yourself is keep your wiper washer liquid full.
Okay.
And normally you do get special liquids that go into your water.
Could we do it water?
Water,
just plain
yes,
water?
But plain water with a little bit of liquid soap could do the trick.
Okay.
Because of the lot of pollution in the air, you get a lot of grime and grit and sticky stuff coming onto your windscreen. So it's better to have some detergent in the water.
Okay.
Then you can also do, what you can do yourself is clean the air filter.
Where is that?
This is how you remove the air filter.
Okay.
Just two clips, pull it out and the air filter is out. Mm-hmm. And if you can get some compressed air, it's better to blow it out from inside to out. If you blow it from this side and blow it out this way.
Okay.
Because normally the air is being sucked in from here. So the dirt is more deposited more on this side. If you blow it in from here, you're pushing the dirt further in. So it's better you blow it out from this side. So you throw the dirt out. And all you need is compressed air for this.
Okay. Can you just dust it otherwise? If there is no compressed air?
You could bang, just tap it. And if you tap it, you'll see that there'll be dust coming out here.
Okay.
You can tap it, but preferably compressed air is good.
Okay.
You can put the filter back now.
Okay. And just clip it again.
Yeah, just
clip it up.
There. And there are these two simple clips. All you do is this. Then always, most of these batteries are now sealed type, so they don't require topping up, but even these, often on because of extreme temperatures, the acid does go down, and so better to top it up, not with acid but with distilled water.
How often do you need to do that?
With the sealed batteries, maybe have a look at it every 3 months, once in 3 months.
Okay.
And try and keep your brake fluid also up. The brake fluid shouldn't go down. It only goes down when the disc pads and brake liners wear out. That's when the fluid goes down. When you replace the fluid, it comes up again. So just keep an eye on that, that the liquid is up. I think that's what should keep your car in top shape.
Yeah. And then, of course, you put the bonnet back down.
Yes. And make sure you put the rod back in its clip.
Yes.
And always do not
drop
the bonnet. Just hold it about a foot above the latch and then release it.
So friends, remember, just 3-4 simple things. Checking your battery liquids, checking the washer liquids, cleaning the air filter, and maybe checking your tire pressure could help you maintain your car much better.
Now for the second tip of the day. You should always keep your car clean.